Plus some New Year's.
Like a winter break.
Yeah, I want to grow my hair back.
Friends, how many of us have them? Friends, welcome everybody. This is episode 10 of
The Movement.
And we are officially live. We officially have hit double digits. This is our first double digit show of the Odd Media Podcast. The first show that starts off our week on a Monday. Just want to give a shout out to these fellas over here. 10 weeks, guys. 10 weeks. It's a milestone. I feel like it is. It's definitely an accomplishment. Congratulations to everybody here. Congratulations again. 10 weeks is a big, big. It's a big step. It's a big step. You know what I'm saying? So y'all been doing a great job showing up every single day. But with that all said, welcome everybody, like I said, to the episode 10 of the Movement Podcast. Today we got the Hamza Show. Basically, it's all about gaming, alright? And we know Hamza, that's what he does 24-7.
Not anymore, though.
He ain't a gamer anymore.
Yeah.
Alright? Ramsey, I'm sorry, can you do me a favor, man? Can you just twist the camera a little bit more towards Zach? Just a little bit. Alright? Because we got Hamza's shoulders, and we ain't trying to say Hamza's shoulders. That's perfect, alright? Hamza, we understand it, alright? Weight gains, alright? Weight room gains, I mean, but we get it. Anyways, in all seriousness, we're talking about gaming. You know, we're going to talk about if it's a good or bad thing. When did we first start gaming? You know, what games were you best at? And of course, our top three favorite games of all time as well. So, you know, those are definitely things that we are going to be discussing today. But before we even get into gaming and all that, obviously we got to give a shout out to our sponsors. And our sponsors of today is the Balkan House Restaurant, as well as we also have the Give to Gain. All right, the Balkan House Restaurant and Give to Gain. So let's start off with the Balkan House Restaurant. The Balkan House Restaurant is a gold sponsor of ours. They are located on 3028 Kniff Street, Hamtramck, Michigan. They're also located, they have a Ferndale location, which is 314 West Nile Mall Road, Ferndale, Michigan. They are famous for their donut kebab sandwich. They even serve breakfast now. All their food is halal. You know, Hamza T talks about the donut bowl. Hamza, what else you got for us over there, man?
Donut sandwich, that's the main two sellers. Also chivapi, which is like meat sausages with bread.
How you liking it?
It's amazing. The bread is amazing.
Okay, you know? And there's some renovations going on at the Balkan Hour. Already went on. They're done, right?
Yeah.
Have you seen the office yet, or she don't let y'all in there?
Well, the office is just, you know, a space for her.
Okay.
So not really.
Okay, that's good though. Yeah. That's good. She needed that. She needed that spot that she could do some work at. But that she never talked about is Juma, by the way. Shout out to Juma Ekic. And shout out to Hassan as well, and everybody at the Balkan House Restaurant, all of the workers, you know, they rock their Oz Balkan House shirts too.
Yeah.
Gotta give it up to them, man, seriously. We gotta respect that, man. I'm much appreciated to them. I really do appreciate them at the Balkan House Restaurant, and all their food is halal. I don't know if I mentioned that or not, and their service is amazing as well. So, shout out to the Balkan House. Shout out to everybody there, and let's get this show on the road. Again, today we're talking about gaming. I know a lot of you love gaming and are all about gaming that are followers of us on YouTube. So here we go. That's what we're going to talk about today. You know, another fun show for the Movement Podcast, okay? With that said, first of all, welcome, guys. Y'all still sleeping over here? Y'all awake?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all had fun last week, Saturday, MSU U of M, crazy game. These guys were all MSU fans, by the way. They showed their true colors in the middle of the game, so I appreciated them. Ramsey was on the building, too.
Actually, I almost got into a fight in school just because I rooted for Michigan State.
A real fight?
No, not a real fight, but just it was a lot of arguing.
Oh.
A lot of my teachers, you know. A couple of them gave me Fs, but it's all right.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah. Well, is it because they won, or is it before they won?
No, it's because I chose Michigan State before the game.
Oh, okay. There we go. There we go. I see some chair covers, by the way, Zach. You just stop in the middle of it. Alright?
Oh, yeah, no time.
Okay. Alright, well, with that said, yeah, that was a great game last week, Saturday, by the way. It was a great game last Saturday. We enjoyed it, but I don't want to talk about that no more. We move on now. We talked about it enough. So, with that said, my first question, okay, and I'm going to pass it on to the gamer himself, okay? Do you think gaming is a good or bad thing for the younger generation? Because everybody is gaming now. Even kids are gaming. When I say kids, 6, 5, 7, 4 years old, going on Minecraft. What's the game that plays Minecraft, right?
Minecraft.
That's the main
Roblox
one.
Is the main
Roblox. That's what I meant to say. Roblox. Taking over these kids'
crazy.
Lives.
It's still the best Roblox
game. All right. So, with that said, Hamza, is gaming a good or bad thing for the younger generation?
So, actually, yesterday, there's an article in my school where, if his gaming is good or not for your health. And there's
it's
a lot
not
of,
random. It's not random, by the way.
It's not random. It's actually, it was studies.
Coincidence.
It's coincidence, you know. But in college, they were doing studies on how gaming is actually good for you. You know, sometimes it can higher your GPA. And playing more hours than less hours, also helps your health, you know. When you're gaming, you're distracted, you don't want to eat or anything like that. So, also affects your health, you can lose weight, people are, messing up with that part. Losing weight is an issue, but it's also very good, mentally and physically.
So, are you for gaming? Remember, the reason why I say younger children is because there's a different demographic. If I say college students, then, I guess anybody, it's a basic question, but I said for the younger generation, so people basically from elementary to high school, before college. Do you think gaming is a good thing?
I mean, it depends on how much time they play on it. If it's more than 3 hours, it's not good.
A day?
Yeah, more than 3 hours a day, it's not good. For younger children, obviously.
Yes.
They have a bunch of other stuff to do, homework, gotta focus on school. Gotta get to college and get a job. That's basically it. That's how I think about it.
Ali Abdullah.
Can you repeat the question?
Do you think gaming is a good or bad thing for the younger generation?
So the way I look at this is that there's goods and bads to it. So I'm gonna start off with the good part. Kids, at that time of age, they're gonna want to play. They're gonna want to play a game and have fun, which is understandable because, that's how we all were when we were younger. And it is good to have a certain time where, you get your schoolwork done, okay, you have your free time, you could, just play. But, bad thing is, what I didn't like what Hamza said was, you're not eating, losing weight. I'm not really onto that, but, if you're, gaming on a phone for a kid, and they're just standing there, sitting there with their neck like this for, 2-3 hours. Oh, sorry about that. For, 2-3 hours, that's not good for their health. And just looking at a screen in general is not good.
Yeah.
And, just sitting in the same spot, that's not healthy for you.
Yeah. And there's been a rise in the kids getting glasses, and I think this all correlates to being close to the screen all day and stuff like that. And, you sitting at home all day doing nothing, take that into consideration as well. But I'm not going to share my part yet. Zach, go ahead. It's on you. Do you think gaming is a good or bad thing for the younger generations?
To me, it's not really a bad thing, It's because, say my children, right? Say when I have, my kids.
Big General's kids. Yeah.
Say they can play video games how much they want. After they do their jobs, or work, their school work, or, after they play sports, they can stay up, do whatever they want with the video games. But you have to, wake up on time for school, though, but,
Big General rules.
Yeah, so it's not really a bad thing.
You don't think it's a bad thing? All right, Yusuf Davids. Here comes Mr. Sophisticated.
Say repeat the question, please.
Alright, make sure you speak louder too, man. Do you think gaming is a good or a bad thing for the younger generation?
For the younger generation, I think that they're supposed to have the most fun while they're still young. And I feel like if they think gaming is the way, then go ahead and do it. But I also feel like that's what separates different friend groups, people who game and people who just play sports and people who do classwork. So I feel like you gotta have a mix in all to have, because it's gonna help you with growing up. You can't be just gaming all the time. So I feel like as long as you mix it up and not just focus on one thing, you'll be fine.
Yeah, so I'm in the middle of it too, man. I think that half of the reason why kids are what they are is because they don't really find something that they love doing, and so therefore they're busy doing stuff that they're not supposed to be doing, and that's what gets them into trouble. So personally, me, I feel like that if you can find something that you love and you do it and it keeps you away from trouble, then go ahead and do it. But I do think that you need a balance. As with everything, you need a balance with everything. So to me, playing it at a certain time, I know you, Hamza, you had like a certain limit, which is great to me. I think that's a great idea, is having a certain limit of pretty much what time you need to be gaming and certain different times of when you should be gaming and limits to it so that you're not overdoing it. And then next thing you know, you're caught up in it. And it's not fun anymore. Now it's when you do too much of one thing, it becomes addictive, and it becomes, you know, like you are, the word I'm looking for is abusing it. So at the end of the day, this I believe in balance. If you're gonna game for 3 hours, I think you should be exercising for that long or playing outside for that long. And obviously 3 hours of exercising and playing is not realistic unless it's like the summertime and you have all day to do that. So therefore, I don't think gaming for 3 hours should be realistic. I think that if you're going to game for an hour a day, you should be able to exercise and play for an hour a day. That's my theory with it. I think that you should be having a balance in your life. I don't think you should just be gaming your whole life. Obviously, there's a bunch of people out there who are successful gamers, but it's rare, you know, because there's a bunch of gamers out there, and there's not that many successful gamers, okay? Right. So let's keep it real, because everybody is a gamer now. So the way I look at it is balance. As long as you have a balance, it's fine. Because we all gamed. You know, everybody games growing up. You know, rather if it's, even if it's you just picking up a controller one time at your friend's house and you play video games. Everybody's been gaming before. I would say if there's, you know, you're in a school of, you know, 1,000 people, I guarantee you at least half of those people have played video games.
More than half.
So I'm just saying at least, you know, so I look at it like people are going to do it. I just think finding the balance is very important. And especially in the wintertime, it's tough to really go outside and do stuff. So instead of, you know, having your kids, I don't know, on YouTube 24/7, which is something that can be bad too, I'd rather have them play video games.
I want to say something, because in games, there's like, you know, PS5 and Xbox, they have like this voice chat, party chat, where you can also communicate with your friends. That's probably why, another reason why gaming is like better than just YouTube and all that.
That you're communicating with other people. Yeah, I mean, that is a part of it too. But, you know, there are people out there like Ali Abdullah who stays up till 2 in the morning playing video games for 6-7 hours. So
that's 6-7 hours.
4 hours, at least.
8 hours, man. Stuff like
that.
Yeah, so
4 hours.
That, to me, you're pushing it right there. That's a little too much
but
to me.
But the thing is, I do... You know,
but
lot,
yeah, but he does do other things. That's why I wouldn't be worried about somebody like him. It's the people that just stay inside all day, that play video game all day, come home straight to video games, might do their homework, plays video games all day. Like, I don't like that. I don't like somebody that just plays video games all day, straight up. Like, to me, there's so many other things you can be doing in this world. You could be reading. You can be writing. You can be working once you get a certain age. You know, so there's other things that you could be doing rather than gaming. So that's kind of my topic on that. Anybody want to add on to that? If not, we move on to the next question. And so the next question is, when did you first start gaming, and then what game did you enjoy playing? What game made you fall in love and say, like, dude, this game right here, I cannot wait to go home from school and play this game? Hamza says Fortnite. So, Zach, what's your... No, it's all good. I'm not starting off with you, Hamza, this time. I'm going to start off with Zechariah Thabit. When did you start gaming, and what game was it that made you fall in love with gaming?
Push.
I started gaming, like, for real, like, every day. Like, a year ago.
Okay, but when did you start playing video games?
I don't know.
He started playing, like, around a year ago, because I remember... When he used to see me play, he used to be like, why are you playing? Like, and then it was not till last year when he actually enjoyed it. So
I hate video games.
Okay, so what game is the game that you go to that is the go-to video game for you?
Like right now?
Yeah.
GTA?
No.
I mean, that's good.
GTA, Dead by Daylight, or Madden right now.
By the way, I'm the new mannequin. I just want to throw that out there. I'm back to my old self.
I heard you next door. Sounded like you were giving it
in to. I was. That's it now, Hamza. They're in a dangerous area right now. All right, this is where Umar found out how to like master what he used to master.
What happened last time you played?
I don't even care about last time we played. I've been smacking every single person that I've been playing. Like in the last 3 weeks, I find out. I don't know what's going on.
Last time me and you played, who won?
I don't remember. I do not remember, huh?
You do random?
Randoms. I don't pick teams.
Very good.
I'll have Jacksonville Jaguars, and I'll let you know what's about to happen. Okay? Anyways, you said, what is your game? What game did you pick?
GTA.
Yusuf. When did you start gaming, and what was the game that made you fall in love with every game that you play?
I started gaming like around like 9 years ago, and I was around like 9, 10 years old. And then, actually, the game that I fell in love with and like went into gaming is when I played with you. It was Lego Marbles, whatever. Mm-hmm. Lego Marbles. Oh, that game was fire.
Don't put me on the spot like that, man. We ain't playing no Lego
Marbles. It was the Lego Adventures Marbles.
I should have said that.
That was a fun game.
That was probably because it came out like around 2012, 2013. Mm-hmm. And that's what made me also fall in love with the Avengers and stuff. But no, that game, it was a great, for sure.
We're teaming up.
Yeah, 100%.
Best believer, I'm going to yell at him whenever he used to mess up.
Messed up the mission. Yeah.
There were some dumb missions, though. Hamza T, what game made you fall in love with it?
Honestly, man, Minecraft, bro. Like, I was like 7 or 8 when I used to go to my friend Amir. Like, he used to live right across the street. Every time we went there.
Champion like Amir, by the way. You got to start giving out these champions, badges when we call out people's names, but go ahead.
Yeah, but we used to play Minecraft, man. And then once I got my Xbox myself, first game I got was a Minecraft edition Xbox. So I got Minecraft with it. Just kept playing it for hours a day, even though it wasn't healthy, but it was my favorite game. Literally, just Minecraft. There you go.
Minecraft. That's a lot of people.
It's literally, you're just building.
There was only one game that I enjoyed playing with him, and it was like Egg Wars or something like that, or Bed Wars.
It was like Bed Wars, but that's like in a future
update. That was fun.
I never liked Minecraft, I don't know.
It's like creative, you could build anything you want, you could defeat the game, you could beat the game.
Minecraft is fun
for me. You grew up in the sporty house, you know, the sport household. So we have different preferences.
There you go. Ali Abdullah, what was it for you?
Man. So, my dad, he already had an Xbox, right? And it was when I was little. It was this one game where...
How old were you, by the way? Do you remember?
I don't remember, but I was like probably like 5 or something. Or 5 or 6.
You had a big forehead, by the way, back then.
Man, you don't call me out like that, man. Anyways.
Forehead gang.
Anyways. So, I don't know if you know. I think it was called the Kinect back then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's where it was like, you know, it was a camera.
Wii.
No, it was a Kinect. It was like part of the Xbox.
Yeah.
It was a Kinect, and it's like a camera. It shows you. My dad, he bought this one game. It's like, you know, you have your own tiger. And, like, you sit in front of the Kinect, and you could pet him. You could play with him. And then I used to just, it was fun.
That's what made you fall in love with gaming.
Yeah.
That game right there.
I used to always play that game every time I go home.
I've never played that game. That's why it's random to me.
And then, like, every time, what's it called? You jump, the tiger would jump. And then, but I couldn't jump too much because it made too much noise downstairs. So my mom ended up putting pillows on the floor. So whenever I jump, you know, it's...
That's nice.
I see how you're doing that.
Yeah.
It was fun, bro.
That's nice that your mom did that, though.
Yeah.
Like innovative. She looked out for you to still let you do what you gotta do while making get that happy, too.
Yep.
Alright, well, there you go. Me, personally, man, it was... I think it was, like Yusuf said, like around 9, 10. I mean, honestly, I don't know what really made me fall in love with it. First of all, we used to have a Sonic Genesis, Sega Genesis, okay?
I think
Sega, the two games I used to love on Sega was Mortal Kombat and Sonic. Those two games were the best games to me on Sega. And then we had the Nintendo 64. Nintendo 64 times, I remember Ibrahim and Musa, they had one too, so... We used to have 4 controllers. Well, we used to have 2, but whenever they used to come over, we had 4, and we played 2-on-2 NBA Live, funny games, MLB. Like, we used to have great times. And then when the Xbox came out, that's when, like, everything changed, because now we're officially into, like, the new age of video games and
technology,
and then it was Madden. It was Madden, you know, that's when Madden became, like, my go-to, up until, like, you know, I stopped playing probably when I got to, like, high school age, and then in college, they went back to playing, and then it was FIFA. So it was, like, it was really, like, phases of life, depending on the age that I was at, and depending on that stuff, so... Those are the games that I like. I don't know if it was really one specific game that made me fall in love with it. I mean, like I said, starting off with the Sega days, it was definitely Sonic and Mortal Kombat. Those were the two best games that we used to always play that was a lot of fun. And we used to laugh and have great times with those games as well. But, yeah, that kind of answers the next that question of when did you start gaming. And so, you know, what game were you best at? That's the next question. And then tell a story. All right, so I got a couple stories. But I'm going to save mine to the end. You know, Hems and Zach already went. So I'm going to let you go first right now. What game were you best at, Eddie? And tell us a story.
Okay. So the game that I'm best at is Rocket League. And the reason why is because, you know, you got the dynamic trio right here. Me, Zach, and
Well, I'm glad you're
Big,
saying...
Big Goalie.
Big Goalie.
Big Goalie.
I'm glad you're saying this story because it saves me from having to say the story like that. But go ahead. What was your best story, Island?
Man, it's a lot, bro. We had, like, so many clutch moments, bro, where we all came through. We won, like, what, how many championships?
I think the first championship was the best one.
The first one was definitely the best
one. You want to know why it was so great? Because we won with all hands. That's why I was saying.
Exactly.
Yeah. How did you ever win a championship?
No, he has not.
Nope.
But
first of all, man,
I can say something. Got three. I got one with him and a computer.
Right. Listen up, listen
he's
up.
He's one of the all-time great players without a ring.
It was, so what do you call it?
Carmelone? He's Carmelone.
Listen up. I was,
Charles Barkley.
Even if I didn't win a championship, I was still the best in that game at my prime. But the reason why I didn't win is because I was on a higher level than everybody else. You guys were on the rookie
not
levels. I was on, like, the silver or gold level.
Not
so every
me.
Player I was playing against was around my level. You know, whenever they played against, it was on their level. Very trash players, basically.
Not than me.
Championship is a championship.
Listen.
It's whatever. Yeah, I don't care.
We won that chip. That was a great moment, man. I ain't gonna lie. That was a top five moment for me in video games.
Also, let's not forget about the tournament that we did at Ali's house.
Didn't you end up winning that one?
Yes, I did.
Oh, Hobbs. We gotta pause right quick.
Hey, man, I beat him in the other one, though, in your house.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did he?
Yeah.
There's only one way to settle this.
I actually have clips of him beating him, like, and him leaving games and videos that I captured him leaving a game.
Play video game. Serious question.
Rockily?
No, just video game.
Yesterday.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, I would play, like, after I get off work or something.
Okay.
Yeah.
Alright.
But I also have clips as well. I have screenshots of scores that I beat him in, like, 5-0, 5-1 or something like that.
The argument of Ali and Hamza was, like, a side thing that happened during Rocket League.
I mean, we all know that I'm better now, like...
We had phases. Rocket League was good for, like, 5 months, where we was just playing that boy every day. It was during quarantine, so, you know, we found, you know, I don't know how Rocket League blasted
into
our lives.
Free game. That's
yeah,
right.
It was free now. So everybody just started downloading it.
Yeah, it was free. Everybody downloaded it, and everybody just started playing it, and, you know, we fell in love with it. I loved it.
So one time I was sleeping over his house, and then I brought the game to him, like, let's play this. And then we were just grinding until, like, 2 a.m., me and him playing it.
And this guy, oh, man, we used to wait till 12 o'clock at night just for those 12 o'clock times. 9 o'clock, 6 o'clock.
I got
we woke up on weekends.
I remember times where I could have played in turn.
We woke up on weekends on Saturdays just to play in the 12 o'clock early game, early tournament, 3 o'clock. It's not good, man. I'm actually glad we're not in that situation no more because, to be honest with you, I don't got time for that no more. But that was a fun little phase. And the biggest thing that made it worth it was winning the championship, because if we didn't win a championship, I'll still be playing to this day. Until we finally won one. So Hamza, I know how you feel right now, Hams, alright? If you need a ring, I got one to donate to you, alright? Can they do that in Rocket League or no?
No, I'm good.
You can't do it?
I'm gonna earn it myself.
Alright, get a bronze championship from me, Hams. Do you want a bronze?
No, I'm good.
Alright, with that said, that was Ali's story. Yusuf, favorite? Oh, what game are you best at? I mean, tell a story. Watch what you say, by the way. Be careful.
Okay. I want to say... Not really sure, man, because there's a lot of games I'm good at, but I'm not the best at, though. So Madden. Probably no, not Madden, man. It's probably I do want to say Call of Duty.
Are you the best at Call of Duty?
I'm not the bro. I'm probably. Addy knows. We got videos. Ask Bilal, our cousin. I played with him, and I was probably like.
Can you be for real now? Like,
I'm dead serious. Call of Duty.
It's all Miguel. He thinks he's the best. What's wrong with that?
Ain't nothing wrong with him thinking he's the best. The question is, we need to also fact check. So fact check right quick. Adi, is he the best?
No,
he's obviously gonna say no.
No, he's not.
Hamza, have you seen him play?
That's not his best game.
I saw him play for the time that how much he played. He's decent.
He knows how to control the game. Don't get me wrong. You know, he knows how to shoot. You know, he knows how to play the game. But he's not the best at it. Is what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
You know, there's a difference between knowing how to play the game. You know, well, he could come in clutch in a couple moments here and there, but he's not gonna, you know, he's not like a great player.
I got a better win percentage than you.
First of all, KD. No, you don't. No, you don't.
KD for sure.
No, you don't. Okay. Your KD is negative.
That's impossible.
Well, it's kills.
It's probably point. It's probably yeah, point 0.64.
All right, kills death ratio is negative. Is this true, Yusuf?
No.
Okay. All right. Well, there you go. That was Yusuf's answer. Of course, it gets challenged by the contestants. You know, it wouldn't be right if it wasn't challenged by the contestants. All right? It would be weird if we didn't challenge each other. Zachariah Davids, on you. What game are you best at? Tell a story.
Man, I don't know what game I'm the best at, bro. Because, like, all my family and all my friends, they're some tryhards, bro. Like,
they try hard?
Yeah.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I ain't. Like, I only played like a year ago, like for real. Like, all the games, like every day, like a year ago. Everybody in this table, they've been playing for like 10 years plus. All my friends, I'd say, like, I like a game, they've been playing it. So, I would say, like.
What game are you best at, though? Like, you're not the best player, but are you best at?
Man, you know, I think I could be anybody. You know, I already did beat everybody. You know, like my friend Abdurrahman, right? This past week, we played 19 games. I beat him 15-4.
You got time to be playing 19 Madden games, Zach. Seems like a lot of time to be playing Madden.
No, we play like three game series a day.
Okay.
And he's not good to me, you know. I be beating him.
Once you beat somebody 15 out of 19 times, you gotta move on to the next.
By the way, like, you'll never see me quit ever in any game. Like, never. I don't know how y'all quit and stuff. Like, Rocket League, I'll never quit. Even if it's 10-0.
The only time I'll quit is if I got something else to do or if there's somebody next to play. I look at it like there's no point in playing anymore.
I'll never quit. You never catch me quitting.
Facts. Big General. Hamza T. Fortnite. Is that the answer?
Actually, yes.
We
it
finally
is.
Have a Fortnite call out.
Actually, yeah, man. I was up there in Fortnite too, man.
Alright, so, you know, back when the game was very fun, me, Ali, and Yusuf, we used to play a lot. But, you know, obviously they moved on to better games. Well, they thought they were better games. But I stayed, you know, I stayed OG to my game, you know. I just kept getting better and better. And as, you know, when they came back to the game, I carried them with a few dubs. You know, they also tried to 1v1 me, and I absolutely demolished both of them. Sometimes it was, you know, 4-1, and I still beat them. You know, also Dawood and Yahya, you know, and Yusuf, you know, sometimes it's 3v1, I still beat them. This is just crazy. I'm just the best in that game. If anybody disagrees about that, then they're just biased. But I'm the best in this table.
You got a story? That's what you said, basically, when they shot a 3VU or
4VU? Story was I carried Ali to his first win and Yusuf.
First Battle Royale? Whatever it's called?
Battle Royale, yes.
Whenever me and Khalid would play with you guys on our teams, we would always beat you guys.
That's cap.
Nah. I always had the upper head. Like, anybody's on my team, we won.
I didn't even need to do as much when I was on his team. I'm going to give it to Hamza. That was his game.
Yo, I see Ramsey out here zooming in, by the way. Shout out to Big Rams in the building. Ramsey, number one game that you're at, Fortnite? For sure?
I don't play any other game.
He don't play any other game. So, Ramsey, Fortnite, that is a marriage made to happen right there. All right? Ramsey and Fortnite, he's been on it. Still on it? Not really?
I see him.
Stop playing. Stop the cap, Rams.
I see him at 12 o'clock. All right. Play the Fortnite duo.
Stop the cap, Rams. Alright. Okay. Alright, well, coming to me.
Hold on. KD ratio, 0.35.
Bro, what is that?
No.
Negative.
No. For those that are watching, that's not KD's number. It's KD, it's a kill to death ratio, even though that is KD's number. 35.
How many? Only 70 games, bro.
Exactly.
All right, what is your KD ratio?
I'm going to show you right now. It's over. It's definitely over. I'm about to show you right now.
All right, while Ali shows us his KD ratio, I am going to tell you that the game that I was probably best at, hold on 1 second, let me just put this down here too. I'm getting my list of favorite video games. I thought about the last one.
I have a 2-game kill ratio. That's embarrassing, bro.
Yeah, what are you waiting for, man? You got it ready or what?
2-game, that's actually really good. 2 right. Kill?
The amount of games you played?
No, that's actually
really good. Are you going to show your new account or your old account?
No, my old account is hacked.
Alright, so let me tell you guys this. What game was I best at? I would have to say Madden. I was the king of Madden, and I'm not going to even sit here and toot my own horn. I had stories to back it up. I used to walk around the neighborhood and tell people, stay away from me when it comes to Madden, okay? My biggest competitor was probably Nash, but Nash knows too. You know, overall these last 5 years, he maybe got me because I haven't been playing video games. But when you talk about when I was in my phase of starting Xbox up until, I'll say, high school times, and then, you know, he knows what's up. But I just remember one big story about Madden is that we had a huge tournament. I've won tournaments before, but we've had a huge tournament. Somebody's on the wire. Hamza, I don't know, it might be you. All right. We had a huge tournament one time at Motzi's old house where Uncle Nash used to own, right next door to, you know, my mom and dad's house, right there. Uncle Nash used to own it, Motzi used to live in it. So, you know, they invited a bunch of people over, you know, they were just trying to watch games, and they're like, you know, let's have a Madden tournament, okay? And Motzi was like, I'm not going to play, I'm going to let Umar play. And I was a sophomore at this time, in high school. And I'm talking about all of Nash's friends, all those guys, Zags and Danny, Abubak. You know, Arfat, you know, Uncle Eddie was there, Uncle Nash, bunch of stuff. But like, it was like 15 dudes, okay? And, you know, of course you had me and over there, and Danny was there too. So, you know, we're hanging out with them, you know, we're playing Madden tournament. I advance after the first round. You know, I advance after the second round. And lo and behold, like, I'm just advancing. And I think I played Nash in the first round or somebody. And Arafat in the second round, and then I played Abubak in the third round, and he had Michael Vick, and I remember Michael Vick was a man back then. And long story short, I shut him down, and after plays, you know, we was getting hype. Mo T was over there hyping up. Like, you gotta imagine, I'm the young buck in there just smacking him one by one. It was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. We also had a FIFA tournament, but I'm not gonna get into detail about that. But what I do want to get into is the most memorable Madden game that I ever had. It was like one of my favorite days, favorite games that I ever played. So there's this kid named Vincent. Shout out to Vincent Henley. You know, we were great friends, still good friends. Shout out to Vincent. But, you know, he won a PSP. It was PSPs when they were hot. You know PSPs?
I have one.
Okay. So PSP. He won a PSP in Kosciuszko. It was something. I couldn't go to it. But they had an Madden tournament, and the winner won a PSP. And I couldn't go to it. I forgot what it was. I don't know if we had basketball. I don't know what it was. I just couldn't go to it. And so he ended up winning it, so he's talking smack. Like, yo, I'm the best Madden player, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, all right, Vincent, we can't let this happen. Okay, we got to make it happen. These games are intense, by the way. Y'all got to understand the anxiety level. Like, in these games, like, you're trying to prove you're the best. You know what I'm saying? And so, I played with older people, but I never really played with people my age, because I used to look at them like, dude, there's no point. You know what I'm saying? No offense, but it was no point. Because kids are not mentally developed to actually play those kind of games. Like, there's smarts that goes into playing Madden. Like, there's actually play calling, decision making. So, but I respected Vincent. Long story short, he's a PlayStation person, I'm an Xbox person. So I was like, dude, the only way we can do this is either you borrow my Xbox for a week or I borrow your PlayStation for a week. I was like, because, you know, it's the real deal. Y'all know how it is. You can't just play somebody in another system. It's not fair. Give somebody an unfair advantage. I was like, we're going to do this. We're going to do this. He gave me his PlayStation. Okay? So I'm playing PlayStation, and, you know, I'm trying to find out my team. And I don't know why the Broncos was my team. And, you know, he tells me, you know, like, how you feel, you ready for next week? I'm like, yo, I ain't gonna lie to you, man. I was like, I'm getting there. I was like, but bro, I love their kick returner. You know, his son's name was something Williams. You know, Devin Williams, Dimitri Williams, something like that. And I kept telling him, man, I love this kick returner, though. I was like, dude, I ain't gonna lie to you. You know, kick returning is, you don't do well on kick returning. But for some reason, I kept on getting some great kick returns with this guy. Like, moving, swerving. So, lo and behold, we come up to the game, we're playing the game, and it was a battle. I'm at his house, by the way. It was a battle, that game. We're going back and forth, back and forth. Then he's in the lead, yeah, Hamza. He kicks a field goal. I think he's up by 5. And it's like, it was like the fourth quarter. I don't know how much time is left. And I'm over there, my stomach is burbling, okay? Because I'm sitting there, like, I talk so much smack, I'm worried about this guy. All right, this guy's about to beat me. You know, you ain't gonna hear the end of it. Like, this stuff, people hold on to this for the rest of your life. Because we never played after this against each other. Never. Ever again, we played against each other after this. So, he kicks it off. And in my head, I was like, ah. You know, like, no. He kicks it off to me, I think. I go to the right. I go back to the left. I juke one dude, yeah, Hamza, and I'm gone for like 102-yard kickoff return touchdown, Eddie. I start going crazy, Zach. Like, I kept warning him, kickoff, kickoff, kickoff. And this guy, kickoff return, yeah, Hamza, for a touchdown, I'm going crazy. Because the kickoff return is, you don't do this. You don't do this no more. You know, like, it's hard. I'm going crazy. He's dizzy. He gets on offense. He can't drive on a fourth down. I stop him. And you know me, I'm one of them nasty players. Come on, I'll run the clock on you, man. After that, I'll run and run and run and run until there's 0 seconds. You know, I remember he had a curtain for a door. He ripped the curtain off. His mom was like, man, be quiet, shut up, Vincent. You know, my, she's complaining, like, he's complaining, and she starts laughing at him, and I'm sitting there, you know, the little yummy kid, like, yeah. I beat him, you know. She probably thought I was a boner. Like, she looked at me with that look, like, who the hell is this little kid over here beating my son, you know what I'm saying? I remember we went to a basketball game later that day, Maltese team, and it was the Cosmos against Clarenceville. They were number 2 ranked. They had somebody that dunked. Maltese team was 7th ranked, upset. They beat him. Like, it was just a great day. It was a great day. But the reason why I mentioned this is a week later, that player got shot and killed. The player that scored me the touchdown.
The kicker.
Out of anybody in the world, anybody in the NFL, I'm not saying, you know, he got killed the next week. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, what the heck? Like, what are the chances, Hamza? You know what I'm saying? It's during season, it was mid-season. I remember it was like in January. I was like, no, what is going on? You know what I'm saying? It was crazy. It was crazy. But long story short, you know, shout out to that guy, you know, man. It was a weird moment, though. I ain't gonna lie. Like, he got shot and killed. I was like, what the heck is going on? But very memorable moment right there. Top 5 moment right there for sure for me. All right, with all that said, I'm sorry, I went on a little rant, but top 3 video games of all time. I'm going to start off with you, Ali. I don't think you started yet, right?
I think you did? I started last, right?
Yusuf didn't start yet. There we go. Top 3 video games of all time, Yusuf. Who are your top 3 video games? Go.
I'm going to say Roblox at number 3. Number 2, I would go with 2K. Number 1, Lego Marvel. All
right. I had to think about that list. Sorry, I'm just thinking about your list right now and how it's like, man, you guys missed out on some great games, guys.
I know.
Yeah, I missed out on some great games.
I said 3 only, bro.
Okay.
See, Mortal Kombat is in there, bro.
3. Zach. Top 3.
Right now?
Not right now, of all time. Well, since you've only been playing.
I'm like, right now? Roblox, Madden, GTA.
Roblox, Madden, and GTA. Hamza.
I'm going to go back to the prime, like the old time. Those are just my favorite games as of right now as well. Mario Castle, which is like, you know, Mario games.
Cat, man.
No, I'm serious. Yeah, I had a Wii. I played on the Wii.
Yeah, we played that, I think.
Mario Castle?
Mario Castle. It's like a story mode type of thing.
Yeah, I know.
Also,
I played it.
Cooking Mama. Or Mama Cook, I forgot, it's either or. It's like on Nintendo 3DS or 2DS, where it's like, you know, that classic Mama, and then you cook all that stuff, shake it up. I don't know if you know, but it's one of my favorite games. And then also, Minecraft. Just have to do the Minecraft, you know, still my favorite game.
I think
number three.
Cooking Mama, by the way. What is that, Cooking Mama?
It's on Nintendo where like you cook, but like she tells you what to cook and there's like multiple levels. Mm. I think there's a game on the phone as well. Yeah. Where, like you separate, like, you put the butter all over the pan, you shake it up.
Cooking Mama.
Yeah, Cooking Mama or Mama. I forgot what the name was.
That's funny. It's Cooking Mama. Go ahead, Ali.
Go with what I have fun with the most, but at number three, I'm gonna say 2K, two Rocket League, and then number one Call of Duty.
Three is 2K, two is Rocket League, number one is Call of Duty. All right, my number three, it has to be Mario Kart, guys. How can you guys not put Mario Kart in? Y'all did not have a phase of Mario Kart, bro.
I had.
My goodness, that game is a. The only reason why it's not one is because the other two ones are sports, and I play these games heavily. But Mario Kart, guys, is the best game in the world. Like, I would literally get a Nintendo 64 just to play Mario Kart. I know a bunch of people my age who buy Nintendo 64s just for Mario Kart. Mario Kart is still $60 in the streets. That's how expensive it is. People still are out here trying to buy Mario Karts. Google how much. I'm on Amazon right now, Mario Kart
video game. I just don't get how racing is fun.
It's not just racing, though. It's with the bananas and...
Yeah, yeah.
More to it.
Dude, it's a lot of fun. It's funny. It's hilarious. Mario Kart, one of the best games, non-sport games. Number two for me was FIFA. I'm a big low-key. People be like, FIFA? But yeah, dude, FIFA was, you know, it's fun. Where is it at?
It's like $40 to $60.
Yeah.
Also had, I actually played Mario Kart a lot. I had, the steering wheel on the Wii. You put the Wii controller? Yeah. I played it a lot. It was a fun game.
And then number one is Madden. You know, Madden has to be number one. That's the game I probably played the most out of every game out there. So that's definitely my number one with that list, all right? Now, with that said, it's 41 minutes into the show. Guess what? It is time for the question game. Right now, the Zach and Hamza combination have won two straight. Yusuf and Ali has been on a slide. Ali, I realized this, man. When was the last time you said an answer to a question, bro? Seriously, when was the last time you said an answer to a question? We need you in the questions game. Yusuf has been doing, we called out Hamza last time, so now we need to call you out. Ali, put the team on your back. All right?
He answered one time, but he didn't say the answer.
I've answered a question before.
He drew a blank. Alright. With that said, alright, we got time for the questions game. And so, like I said, Yusuf and Ali's team is still in the lead, 3-2. Make sure Ali's not cheating or looking at my screen. Alright?
Make sure Ali's not cheating.
He's the closest one.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm not advice, okay?
Yes.
Say the question, just say it.
No.
What is this?
No, I'm gonna say what is this?
No, you gotta almost, say it all the time. Quick, so that you can guess.
No. Here we go. Are y'all ready? What game makes this sound?
See? That's it. Hit it right before you hit it.
Sonic.
That question is taking away.
Oh my god.
I just said what game, and then you pressed the button, Zach.
And you heard the sound. Sancho.
Yes. Because they smacked it? It's okay. Just move the sign then. Just move the sign. You can take the sign away. Alright, you can start working on Oz Media, because you don't even have to worry about doing that. So you can start fixing the Oz Media one right now. Alright, what's going on, man? Why are you guys not even letting me do this, bro?
Right.
Slow down, man. Slow down with the buzzer. Slow down with the buzzer. I just lost the question.
That's a negative one. Honestly, it's negative one.
All right.
I hit it before.
No. All right, it is negative one.
Anyways, good luck with trying to smack in these ones. Number one selling video game of all time.
No answer. No answer.
Do you guys have an answer?
Number one selling video game of all time?
Yes.
I had an answer, but I don't want to say it.
Get creative. It's all time.
No answer.
Tetris.
Nobody
knows.
What? What is that?
I actually specifically came up with four questions because I had a feeling y'all might not get this, but now I gotta still come up with a question.
What's Tetris?
Alright.
Yeah.
Here we go.
That?
Number one selling video game of 2020.
Fortnite.
Sorry, you can't even sell Fortnite.
Thank you.
It's free.
What?
Wah, wah, wah. Hold on.
Freaking classic.
Minus one for Hamza, I mean, yeah, for Hamza and Zach's team, Ali and Yusuf, well, you don't get a point, but y'all already it's up one. It,
what is it?
All right, the answer is Call of Duty.
So I knew it, bro. I knew it.
I don't have to come out. Question, if you guys get this right.
I'll put it on the negative.
They're negative one.
No, so they're negative zero. 1-0, okay, yeah.
So yeah, negative 1-0. So if you get this right, I don't even have to come up with a question, and I'm not going to come up with a question.
Zach.
All right.
I sold
twice.
Are you guys ready? Are you guys ready? All right, next question, okay? All right. What game makes this sound?
Yes.
No answer. No answer.
So it's answer. You have to play it.
No, it's not. If it's no answer,
no.
There's no point, nothing.
No, you have to play it.
There's no answer, I'm what?
5, 4,
bro.
3,
Tetris.
2,
wait, you played the sound?
Come on.
Is that the sound or is that like...
I think you have to play the question
after.
You can't
play the sound after I said no answer.
No way!
Negative 2 points.
You don't get -2 points.
You guys lost.
Is that Mario?
No, 4-2. Game is over.
First of all,
time
out. How they... They have 0.
Yes. You got -2.
No, it's so dumb.
Bye.
Is that Mario?
Bro, they got it wrong. How did you get them to play it?
Is that Mario?
Time's up. First of all,
it is Pac-Man.
Pac-Man.
Oh,
first of all,
God.
I was thinking about that.
Time's up. First of all,
time's in. You lost. Questions are over. Questions are done.
First of all, my first.
Zach, you sold.
Question.
Yeah.
How about for them? You just stopped the question for them because you stopped it early. Did he?
He did.
Yeah,
and I said no answer. Then he
said no answer.
So
did you want me to? Because you hit the button and I didn't finish it. Okay.
You did.
Okay, here, Zach. Here, you guys are at -1. Congratulations, you still lost. -1.
Okay, and all the questions have a question. Right. So they get a point.
Game is over. Take the L. Okay, take the L. Sorry, guys.
What rule?
You got -2.
What rule? If you get the wrong answer, you get -1.
Me, my rule.
What the heck is that?
You lost.
Who gets
-1? You were very quiet the last 2 weeks. Now you want to start complaining. Take the L.
I guess every answer from last week. What are you talking about?
Thank you guys for watching the questions game. We are now moving on to our word of the day /4 bars segment.
Right.
And today's word of the day is procrastinate. Now, I'm going to call out these boys at the table because I hope that they all are... Well, the reason why I came up with this word, obviously, we're talking about gaming. And, you know, some people say gaming leads to procrastination as well. So I figured that this would be a good word to kind of correlate with one another. But I also heard that the boys at this table here, and I'm going to call you out because I'm going to call out everybody that don't take some of the stuff that they need to be doing seriously. And what I mean by that is praying, okay? You know, so not to specifically call out one person here, but I do want to just quickly mention that it's very important to do some of the things that you do. Now, I'm not trying to be religious, and for people that I don't follow the religion of Islam, you don't got to do what you got to do. But my advice to you is that once you're at an age of where you're required to do that, you should be doing it. It's the least that you can do. The reasoning why I have what I have is I sincerely believe is that I'm not a perfect person. I have a lot of mistakes, and I can say that straight up to your camera, all right? I can sit there and name off to you. There's not enough fingers of all the things that I've, you know, problems that I have. But at the end of the day, the least that you can do is pray, and I think that it's very important to do that because you get a lot of answers when you do that too. You get a lot of guidance when you do that. It's very important. It gives your life balance. And when you are doing it, it's supposed to make you feel relaxed, you know? And so, you know, y'all need to make sure that y'all on top of y'all game when y'all do that. If y'all want real success in life, that's where it comes from, all right? If you want real success in life, that's where it comes from. And procrastination has a lot to do with it. When you push something off for a long time, next thing you know, you're not doing it anymore because you pushed it off for so long that it's a foregone conclusion. All right, there are some things in life that you're supposed to procrastinate, but there are some that you just say, it's for sure no, and I can't do that. So the definition of procrastinate is to intentionally put off doing something that should be done. So the word is procrastinate. Who wants to go first?
I'll go first, I don't care.
All right, here we go. Procrastinate.
Let me get it up. All right. I like to do things on time, so I don't procrastinate. So much opportunity, just gotta open the gate.
Oh.
We have so much stuff, why can't we appreciate?
Okay.
I use I use you like a stepping stone, just like a crate.
Okay.
Mm. I ain't trying to hate, but being second place is your fate.
Who you talking to?
I ain't about to point fingers, but he knows what I'm talking about.
No!
And it's not on this table, all right? Don't worry about that. All right. I feel bad for this table, for these two tables. Yes.
What happened?
I feel bad for them, you know, like,
you stop.
Yeah, that's why I stopped.
You move on.
Them, you know? Yeah.
I see what you're saying. Zach can't stay still right quick, alright? Zach, you got the bars ready?
Yeah.
Yusuf, you got bars ready?
No, I do not.
Why not?
I was
there. Okay, how about you, Ali? Are you coming up with something right now?
Not this week, bro.
Alright, we got two people sleeping this week. Go ahead, Zach.
You know, if I say the word wrong, it's not my fault, you know?
Don't judge you.
Yeah. General. My name is Virginia, so you know I don't procrastinate.
Oh.
Hamza's not big dog yet. He's still just a bait.
Oh.
Tomorrow I'm about to take Ali's girl on the date.
Oh.
I need to tell her I'll be waiting at the front gate. Use him as the little, I can bench press his weight. Hamza's hairline looks like it's coming in late.
Alright, well, let's clap for Hamza and Zach. Alright, for both of those guys. Alright, clap it up for both of those guys. Not bad. I appreciate it, though. I appreciate you guys coming up with bars, seriously. These guys right here, I don't get it. I don't get it. Literally, I'm writing this as you guys are walking in. I'm writing it as y'all walking in, alright? Just a little bit of fun. I could literally just put something together, alright? One thing I can't stand is someone who is always late. Someone who makes excuses and procrastinates. You gotta be up early if you wanna be great. You know I'm always hungry, like give me my plate. So don't procrastinate if you know what I'm saying. And especially don't procrastinate when it comes to your praying. First step is praying. Second step is praying on time. Alright? I'm a sincerely person when it comes to this stuff. I know people don't like bringing religion into stuff, but I'm sorry. I would not be here and be the person I am today if it wasn't for that. And I don't care if you don't like what I'm saying. I'm going to say it because that's the least that we can do as people is do that. You know, be good people and pray because it can open so many doors for you and you guys don't know it yet. And I believe it's the cheat code in life. I'm serious. When you pray, you ask for something and it gets given to you. That's the way to do things. So with that said, before we do go on, I didn't mention our second sponsor, which is Give to Gain. Shout out to Give to Gain. It is a nonprofit organization that sponsors orphans in Yemen. 100% of all donations goes to the less fortunate. Why Yemen? It's the largest humanitarian crisis and aid operation. 5 million people are at risk of famine. 15 million people need water or sanitation support. Give to Gain. Their Venmo is @give2gain. Their Zelle is 313-445-8638. Cash App, #money_give2gain. The money symbol, not hashtag. The money symbol, give2gain. Shout out to Rico for bringing light on this situation. You know, those are people that are, I know are praying. They are praying. When they don't have nothing, they're still praying. So, shout out to the people in Yemen. I hope they get through at least some of their problems. Because some of their problems, you know, it's just hard to get through very that easy. Anybody want to end it off for Monday motivation? Anybody got any Monday motivation? Hamza, I'm looking at you. You're the guy.
I'll just say something short. It's a few words. You know?
Okay.
You know, when you struggle, like struggling, like it makes sure, like, yeah, you'll do better, you know? Like, you know, nothing's easy. Like I said, I'm probably repeating a bunch of stuff. But, you know, if you struggle, I forgot what the word is, but like shows that you'll do great afterwards, after the struggle. Like, let's say, you know, you're working a hard day and you look at your paycheck. Oh, wow, look, I made all this. The struggle was worth it. Exactly, it was worth it.
The struggle is worth it.
I'm going to say too.
Nothing that's worth it comes easy. All right, just want to throw that out there. But go ahead, Zach.
I got this from my uncle Nash. Last Saturday, we were playing 1v1, right? In the first game, I won, and I didn't miss. The second game, I made two twos, I think, right, or three. Score was with a seven. So I had like six or four. And then he told me, don't miss. You miss, you lose. Next shot, I missed. I ended up losing both the games.
That
was motivation?
So the motivation is, you miss, you lose. So don't miss.
All right, there we go. Yeah. do not miss your opportunities, is what you're trying to say, alright? Because, well, at least you took your shot, though. At least you took your shot. Some people don't even take the shots, Zach. Oz Media 313 YouTube is where you can listen to us. You can watch us. You can listen to us on Oz Media, Apple, and Spotify podcasts. Oz Media 313 is where you can watch us on YouTube. Give these guys thought, any topic ideas, guys, you guys bring them out. That's what we're here for, you know. Inshallah, our goal is to have a show every week, so, you know, we want to expand the topics. So if we start talking about stuff, and you'd be like, oh, maybe you should talk about this, let us know. We'll do it. We'll dedicate a whole show to it. All right? Any final words from you guys?
No.
All right, this is episode 10 of The Movement.
The Movement.
Hope you guys all have a great rest of your week, and we will see you all next week. Take it easy.